As we move on, economy is devastated. We now are talking about post-COVID recovery. This is what we want to address effectively in this country. This is very important, because if we do it properly, we can emerge from destruction to a developed society. Today, as you've been told also, is a world's anti-corruption day. And what an occasion to celebrate, to remember this in a church. Anti-corruption. You see, corruption is a major issue in our country. But corruption is also in the Bible. There are several other places where it is mentioned. I was talking to somebody there, and I reminded him about the book of the in the Acts of Apostles, the story of Ananias and his wife, who sold a property and retained some money that were not supposed to retain, because they had been tempted by the devil. That was an act of corruption. Corruption is all over the place in this country, and corruption diverts a lot of resources meant for developing our country into private people's pockets. And that's the reason why the government is not able to provide certain services, because the money which is supposed to be going for development is eaten by people who don't deserve to do so. So this is an issue that we must address effectively as a country. And the church should be leading. As things stand now, church itself is a culprit. Some churches are being used for purposes of laundering money which have been ill-gotten through corruption. The thieves who have stolen public money ran to churches. They keep on asking church leaders, when are you going to invite me for a rambe, so that I can come and make donation to your church? And when he comes to make that rambe, he makes other demands, that he wants support from the church for his other evil things. Right now you see churches speaking double speak. You see a leader confronting the president. Wait for us. We as church, take us on board. You have views. Where were they when people were giving church views to the steering committee? Where were they? This process has been on with us for the last 2 years. And church had equal opportunity like anybody else to give their views. What is it that you want which is not included in the BBI? Tell us. Tell us. Otherwise, you will be speaking double like those other politicians. And you don't want churches, leadership, to be part and parcel of corrupt politicians. Consultations have taken place, but you cannot take everything on board in a constitutional amendment. What is not on board today in the BBI will come.